streaming. Okay. Yeah. Okay. So now I'm ready. Yeah. Good. So, I want to continue with my 2D renderer of my 3D engine. This window. Last. Okay. No, I can't go on. Programming. Okay. So, okay, what do I need? Okay. Oh, 9999. N? Ist da noch N? Da wird das gesetzt. Doesn't look about right to me. Okay. Yeah, okay. Ah, okay. Ah, okay. Ooh, now it works. Yeah. Now I can remove this little bait thing again. Okay, I guess now I need some transparent texture now. Let's make something. Opa. This right one. Hello. Okay, and make it transparent. Image. No. Was it color? Color to alpha. Wow, okay. Almost transparent. It just looks a little bit transparent because of the black background. Ah, weird. Ah, okay, yeah. I see. Transparency. Ooh, it's transparent. Nice. I've got transparent 2D stuff on top of 3D stuff. Time for a commit. Okay. Now it's time for some documentation again, which is always great. Operation 2D object. Okay. Right, it's created. Same thing default. Yeah, okay. I put it here. I'm glad that transparency works now. Okay. Nice screenshot. So, back to a documentation. Sprite is created one usually doesn't. Simply doesn't. Want to simply display the pink default texture. Now the 2D textures just need to be cleared if the user wants to do so. So it shouldn't be a big issue. It's a little bit boring because I wrote very similar code for my 3D textures. So I just need to change a few things and it should work with 2D stuff as well, but yeah. But like I said, it's not extremely interesting to see or to do. What? Ah, okay. This is a nicely looking line of code. Some dereferencing and hitting the address again. Okay, now I should be able to delete something. Right test. So text. What? Okay, it should display the default texture and not something black. But the texture seems to be deleted. Objects. Interesting. Delete the texture before I actually use it. I get the default texture then. Yeah, I do. Okay, yeah. Then I have to change something in the renderer. Okay. Alt texture, where are you? Okay. There. Okay. If current texture zero, then current to the texture, what texture? Okay. Meh. Boring. I have to change my test first. Why? Meh. I have the sun texture. I think there was some OpenGL function to check if something was a texture. OpenGL texture check. No, that's it's the image. There it is. Line texture. No. No shader stuff. Oh, okay. Yeah, this is interesting with the texture units. Damn. Why do I flip it myself if STBI has its own function to flip something? Yeah. OpenGL test to check. Does it exist? Ah, Okay. Yeah. There it was. GL is texture. It's okay, GL true if it's used. No. Okay. Now. No, it does what it is supposed to do. Okay. Great. Now you can create 2D textures. You can use them and you can delete them. And if no texture is assigned to a sprite, then we simply see the default texture, which is a lovely pink. Ooh. But cool, cool, pretty cool. Okay. It can be deleted. Now I have to add rotation again. Test, no. Ah, here it is. There's no active 2D texture assigned to the sprite, then the 2D default texture will be side. Next, rendering. Yeah, of these sprites. Okay. This is my 3D Engine's GitHub page, and I'm here to check if documentation looks fine. Yeah, because sometimes I'm doing some weird stuff and then it looks weird. Okay, yeah. And I found something that looks weird. Yeah, and apparently I should move my 2D stuff after the 3D stuff. Okay. Okay, yeah. 2D. Oh. This quartz cubes, costumes, lighting, setting parameters. Okay, it's what kind of parameters? Handling of input here. Okay. My documentation. I don't know. Yeah. Okay. 2D input. Does it look weird in any other place? It's... yeah, that makes sense. No, I guess it's fine. Okay. So. Okay. So, I'm back. Okay. Now I'm done with what I wanted to do with this 2D things thing. Now I have to think where I should continue next. Okay. What would be a good thing? I guess text would be important. And it shouldn't be insane. And yeah, that shouldn't be an insane amount of work, because I already have the basic stuff for 2D renderer now. So yeah, it would be just a few additions, I guess. Yeah. But then I need more dependencies. Ah, okay. Wow, that's luckily not an issue for me to find some library files and add them manually in Visual Studio. Okay. So, but I have to do other things. Okay. Yeah. Let's check it somewhere else. Source. Text. And yeah, SDL2, SDLTTF. In it. Okay. Was it? Yeah, it's TTF init. And TT quit, where is it? It's, oh, makes sense. Yeah, TTF quit. Okay, then I'd have to STL to TTF. Okay. Looks pretty circular. But I would like to see some documentation. I want to know if it has some return value. Docs framed. Okay. TTF init. Okay. Okay. 0 on success. Minus 1 with error. Okay. Yeah. Okay. I want to make a function so that I can create a new 2D texture out of a, yeah, basically an image or an array of pixel data. So what do I need? I need a pointer, image data. I need. New. Why? Yep, I think this is about it. Yeah, my idea is that if I can make this function work, then I simply can use it to create these rendered texts, STL, yeah, STL2, TTF, and create these pixel data arrays, and I can put them through this function and use them as regular textures. That would be actually quite cool. And this, yeah, and this would make it useful to have these 2D objects, because texts are not sprites. At least not really. I mean, no, not really. Oh, well, don't be gone. So, Okay. 2D texture new from okay. It's great. Now I actually need the function. isn't it fun to simply copy your own stuff? But I need a lot of similar things. Yeah, I need malloc. Need to create a new texture and bind that parameters or parameters. Now this can be gone because I don't need STBI. Because I don't load data from a file, I just need a memory address. Keep image. I'm not sure if I need to flip it. I will see, but most likely I have to, because of OpenGL, and this thing. Okay, let's flip, this should be image data, GL unsigned byte, RGBA. Rests. That's why. Yeah. That should. Okay. Ah, okay. It's here. Let's make it right text. Okay, but then I have to move this. Okay, test text. Two pixels. No, okay. Okay. Hmm. Doesn't look right, I would say. Okay. Okay, it simply isn't visible. Oh. Maybe I should make it totally transparent. Because that doesn't really help. Now I see something. But I guess I need other parameters. Why do I have GL repeat? GL textures. I guess, well, okay, GL clamp to edge, probably right one. Ah, looks better. Okay, so the function apparently works, but I have to test some more. I want to put it in the middle. I've changed it to 3 and 3. Yeah, it's totally flipped. Then I have to flip it around. But luckily I know how it works and I don't have to use this STBI function to do it. Okay, I have it. Yep. image flip. Okay, this is 4, 4. Oh. Okay. Yes, I have to make alias pointer. How to name it? Image data. Okay, that it hopefully makes sense. Image data. Okay. Malloc function. Ah, okay. Now it's in the right orientation. I'm thinking if I can create textures this way, and apparently it works now, then I can make funny little things like customizable crosshairs for FPS games or something. I mean, I still have my FPS game engine demo, which is this one, and since I created this demo without the ability to render 2D stuff, I moved this, I don't know, it's still some kind of crosshair, but I moved this little red ring into the middle of the screen, so it acts as a as an crosshair. Yeah. But having a real crosshair would be a little bit cooler. And I wouldn't yeah, and I would save some time if I create a new weapon, so I don't have to actually position it that it perfectly fits into the middle of the screen. I want to, yeah, okay, but this is only the case if I want to aim down the sides. Okay, but great, I've got a new function. And that's a pretty cool one, I would say. It can be quite helpful in cases. Documentation. That's cool. Okay. Text should be. Yeah, text should be a 2D object. Okay, oh god. Yeah, I think I will end soon. Or stop, yeah, I will stop the stream soon. Because I'm getting tired. Text objects should be 2D objects, which should make sense, at least it does to me. And yeah. And the engine will differentiate between sprites and text objects, but deep down they are still the same. Just their their content creation process is different. Yeah. Okay, then you can scale and rotate the text, but how do I put these fonts into the picture? I have to load them and I can simply add them as some kind of resources, like other stuff. I mean, in most cases. Yeah, not in most cases, basically always. Textures are some different kind of resource, and they can be added. So I guess I will add text as some kind of 3D object. T3.h. That's programming. Just include the header. Okay. New folder. Plus. Okay. Then have to load and delete fonts again. Yeah, new file, fonts h, then pt. Okay, how do I have this? Okay, fx. Fonts, p, h. Yeah. Stage. I have to into the GF. X header, is it? Okay. Oh god. Ah. Yeah. Okay. Yeah. I guess I have created the files for next time, basically, and the next time I have to load fonts and use them to create these text objects, which can be moved and scaled and rotated like other 2D objects. And then, yeah, then I should basically have it. Yeah. Oh God, I don't even know why, but maybe it's the weather because it's raining and gray. Yeah, but I'm becoming pretty tired. And, yeah. I would say see you next week. I will stream next week on Friday again, starting on at T at T. What am I saying? I'm starting on 2 p.m. CET, Central European Time. Yeah. Then thanks for watching, and have a nice weekend, I would say. So, bye.